Hello and welcome to Young Turk, the show that puts the spotlight on two young achievers every single week and takes you through their journey to success. I'm Shireen Bhan and joining me on the show is Anita Balagopalan. Hi Anita.
Hi Shireen. My guest for today is one of India's most prolific ad filmmakers. Meet Abhinay Deo, but that's a little later on the show. But now it's back to Shireen.
My guest today has an impressive success story. He turned entrepreneur at just 22 with 50,000 rupees in his pocket, and 6 years down the line, the company that he founded, Magnum Solutions, is turning in revenues of 2.5 crores. Let's catch up with Vineet Bajpai, the founder of Magnum Solutions, also an author and a teacher. All of that at just 28.
Bajpai, what it takes to be an entrepreneur at 22, and you'll get some straight talk. Willpower, a small but solid team, and faith in oneself. Armed with a degree in economics and an MBA, Vineet kickstarted his career with a short stint at GE Capital. But within 6 months, he decided to follow his heart and get into the tech business independently. Magnum Solutions, a web-based interactive media company, came to life in a rented generator room with two computers, 50,000 rupees in capital, and three other committed entrepreneurs. Magnum now has chalked up over 700 clients in 6 years and does business worth $500,000 a year. But the beginning wasn't exactly a dream start.
Sometimes it's good to be 22 when you start a business because you don't really do all that due diligence which is required. And as they say, that sometimes when you do too much of thinking and researching, you move from analysis to paralysis. So when I was just 22, I did not really research so much. It was more of gut feel. Yes, it took about a good 6 to 8 months for me to decide that I was going to do this and finally decide how I was going to do this. And I was working, during those 6 to 8 months. And after that, as you rightly said, we started in a generator room and, which was on the top floor of a building in Lajpat Nagar and in New Delhi. And it was the summer month of May, on the 9th of May, that's our annual day we started. And we used to, we were three, four of us, and we used to get roasted in that little room because we didn't even have money to put blinds on the glass windows.
Blood, sweat and tears.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Not
absolutely.
Just metaphorically.
Absolutely. Yeah. And when we look back at those days now, we feel really proud and we laugh about it and we feel, we hug each other. The four of us are still together and we hug each other and it was very exciting. Yeah.
So 700 clients now, but when you bagged your first one, it couldn't have been an easy task to actually go and sell yourself. What was that experience actually like to tell people that, listen, bet on us, we're worth it?
Okay. The first business that we got wasn't really too much of a big bet for a client because it was very, very low value. And but I do agree that, it's very tough when you go to a client and say, look, this is who we are. And he says, okay, who all have you worked for? And you say, nobody, you're the guinea pig. Mm-hmm. So it was very tough. But I think when you're really determined to get something going and when you're, you've sold the idea to yourself and you believe in yourself, I think it starts showing in your face. And there are always a whole lot of people in this world who would want to trust newcomers, who would want to give them opportunities. And I think we were lucky in that sense.
So there was no disappointment initially when you were actually starting off with doors being slammed in your face? There, that's the typical entrepreneurial story of sort of clients saying, no, well, we need to give somebody else a shot because they've probably got a lot more experience. How much of that played a part in you wanting to strive and achieve the kind of success that you have met with?
A lot. I think that was one of the biggest drivers because what happens is I think it is failures which make you thirsty for success, And when we started out, you're very right. I won't name an organization, but there was a guy who almost threw us out, threw one of my people out of his office because my person was insisting to sell and would not move out of the office. So we've seen a whole lot of that. We would go to big organizations and they would ask us, how many people are you? What's the kind of infrastructure? Can we do an office visit? And there was a no for everything, So it became very tough. But I think it was we just knew that we had to do it. We burnt all our other bridges. We just knew this is the only thing we're going to be doing. And we just carried on. And I think it was just determination which initially helped us.
So what was the big turning point, really?
The big turning point was, I think, when we started working for, the Japanese multinational Daikin Air Conditioners. Mm. That was the first client we could actually start going and talking about to other clients and, start telling them about, that this is what we've done. and we're still very good friends with the people who had initially given us that project. But I think what really established us as a good, credible company, a credible organization, was when we won the tender of the Ministry of Finance website.
The corporate services that Magnum now provides, because obviously you started somewhere, now you're 700 clients down the line. What's the scope of services that you actually provide?
We are a full-service, comprehensive interactive media company, you know, where we would undertake work which is as simple as designing web pages, right down to connecting, global offices using the internet platform. You know, so we are a full-service interactive media company in the sense that we design websites, we develop online applications, we do internet marketing. We are, in fact, I would say we are amongst the best in internet marketing in India. Mm-hmm. And along with that, a lot of value adds like animation and multimedia, online gaming, you know, those kind of things.
Hard work, sweat, and a lot of struggle. That's been life for Vineet Bajpai. While he's lost out on his interests and hobbies, he has no regrets. He's aiming at making Magnom the number one player in web-based solutions in the next 5 years. So would scaling up mean selling out?
As far as the private equity participation is concerned, we would look at that because we would want to ramp up the scale at a certain stage in life. But what we want to do right now is we want to reach a certain level based on our own revenue accruals.
Okay.
You know, we would probably want to spend another 2-3 years reach a scale where we are, we are multi-locational, we've got offices, you know, several places in India, maybe a couple of offices abroad, a certain scale where our valuation could probably be far better than what it would be today.
What is the kind
and,
of valuation?
No, I have no idea. No, we don't really have that.
Okay. So you're currently operating headquartered out of Delhi, and
yes.
You said that you have a plan of where you'd like to see yourself maybe 3 or 5 years down the line.
Yeah.
Give us the sort of ideal picture of where you see the company growing to.
See, I'll just tell you our vision statement. You know, I'll just tell you what we envision. What we envision is that we would want to be the number one player.
And you're
player,
the vision driver within the company, aren't you?
I wouldn't say that. I think I am, as they say, just barely first amongst equals because I have a lot of very, very good people with me who are probably equally talented, equally driven.
But are you more the operations man or are you more the sort of strategic planner?
Mostly strategic because it transformed actually. You know, there was a time when I was the operations man, the business development man, the client servicing man, the accountant, the receptionist. You know, I was everything at one time. But I gradually started, delegating those things. And today I am more in a directional role than operations.
Building from scratch is what this 28-year-old has done and excelled in. So he decided to put his story on paper. Bajpai's first book hit the stands in September 2004 and is a beginner's guide to entrepreneurship. He's now working on his second title, The Barbarian Manager, a non-fiction document inspired by his experiences with B-School grads.
I was an accidental author because what happened was that this was about 4 years when I had, been with my company.
Mm.
And I used to lecture at a lot of places. You know, I like
to... Were you taken seriously because you were, what, 23 or 24?
No, there were so many times. there were so many times when I would walk into the class for the first time and I would go and stand in front of, the blackboard and one of the students would say, Vahani, come here. You know, so... And then somebody would come and introduce me as their teacher.
Yeah.
But it was exciting. But so what happened was that during those lectures, I saw there were a lot of questions, a lot of youngsters who really wanted to know how to start a business, what does it really take, you know, what are the really the practical story behind an entrepreneurial organization. So I started writing an essay.
Mm.
You know, I thought I'll just write about a 10-12 page essay on what is it that you're supposed to do and all the things that I had been through and safeguards and, so that other people do not really have to reinvent the wheel. And when I started writing, I realized that the introduction took about 20 pages, so which is where I thought that
might as well convert
into a book. Yeah, but it was I wrote it with a lot of sense of purpose, and I really believe in every word that is written over there, and every word, every line in that book is actually original. Where every business model, every idea, everything is just an outcome of my practical. Learning for the first 4 or 5 years of business.
Well, that's the book that's already been written. I believe there's another one in the making. Give us a quick snapshot or a preview, if you can, about what's coming up.
Okay, it's like saying that the first book was built from scratch. You know, how do you really create a company from nothing? And the second book is called The Barbarian Manager. which of course the name is slightly spicy, I know, but
it's
but it's a book about how to sustain success. You know, and my first book was about how to create it for the first time.
Shouldn't it be how not to be a barbarian manager?
Well, I'll leave that to the readers. Okay. That's where all the suspense lies.
Okay. Yeah. But so when are you going to be done with it?
I think another 6-8 months, and my publisher, India Research Press, is also eagerly waiting.
Well, we wish you the very best of luck on this journey, Vineet. Thank you so much for taking time out to be with us on Young Turks, and we hope that the company and the books go from strength to strength.
Thank you so much.
Thanks very much.